Sorry, that was cheesy. All right, let me ask you guys a question. Does anyone know where the Columbus landfill is?
Yes.
You do?
Yeah. It's south.
Where is it?
It's like south by Grove City.
Yeah. I was actually not surprised that somebody said that. Because usually there's a disconnect between our society today and our trash. Once you throw it in the bin, goes out on the dump truck, it's gone from your life forever, right? Today I'm talking to you about solid waste, generally the trash and the recycling that are a part of it. I hope to use this subject, like Anne said, to help vocalize what I know better and convey my point without using tons of scientific jargon. Many of you guys may know that I care about this subject. I'm fairly knowledgeable about it from any number of my table topics or speeches, from my New Year's resolution to pick up two pieces of trash a day, which for this last year's resolution, I'm still going strong, so it's no longer really an end of the resolution, it's more like a habit now, which is great. But today I'm going to talk to you about two main things to do with landfill and recycle. First, I'm going to talk to you about the costs associated with landfill and pollution prevention. Second, I'm going to talk to you about the cost of recycling and the materials associated with that. First, for pollution, I need to go over a couple points. The costs associated with pollution for my point of my speech is for protecting the these things in the landfill to keep us healthy. Once we put trash into the landfills, they decompose. Each of our different trash pieces has different chemical compositions, and as they decompose, they can combine into different, more harmful chemicals. Plastics are a good example of this, because well, right now they're benign in a plastic bottle. Once they decompose, they can break down and create what the scientific field, at least the environmental engineering field, calls leachate, which is just a liquid that settles at the bottom of the landfill. And this leachate is toxic. And so in order to mitigate this and keep us protected, we line the bottom of our landfills with what's called geotextiles. But this, for your purposes, it's kind of like a tarp, but just like on a grand scale and on steroids. And since they're on such a grand scale and so technologically advanced, they're expensive. It's not on average, but upwards you can spend $1 million per acre in order to build a landfill. So once you get up to tens to hundreds of acres, that gets expensive, that builds up. And along with the construction of the landfill, the maintenance of the landfill costs a lot of money as well. It's about $1 million per acre per year to maintain the landfill. And along with this comes testing, which is a good example for me to, because it's testing for groundwater pollution, but you don't just have to test during life of the landfill, you actually have to test at least 30 years into the future after the landfill closes. So that adds to the cost. But all of this cost is necessary for our public health. And in doing that, landfills are generally increasing in cost. That brings me to recycling. Recycling is not free. There's collection associated with it, similar to trash. There's processing, and we need to clean it. Because you can't just have, not a good example, you can't have just your apple cider vinegar sitting at the bottom of your glass jar. You're fine. But a fun fact that I saw when I was researching this was Franklin County Landfill said that 7% of the stuff that goes there could be diverted to recycling or the yard waste programs or composting, which I thought was really interesting. Now, secondary demand is high for it. There are other materials that are less economic to recycle, like glass, for instance. It depends on how far you have to transport the glass in order to get it to the recycling plant. It's heavy, it costs money to transport, and while it is recyclable, it may not, the cost associated with collection may not turn out. Plastics are similar to that, but that's more because there's less of a demand for the secondary market, and it's very cheap to make on the first time around. Oh, I forgot my goodies. So my plastic, or my reusable bags back there, are made out of recycled plastic, as well as my unique little poo-poo paper. I think it's made out of moose droppings, which has got the cannon on there, so it's... That's just a little piece of home right there. Anyway, back on subject. We are a consumer society. It's not likely to change anytime soon. You might have heard of the old adage,